I'm Nilesh Sarawate. Good morning, friends. Good morning, sir. I had a Rakhi sister called Zoya. Zoya and me were educated in Bombay in the same colony and in the same school. Right from the beginning, right when I was a child, I was 4 and she was 2. We were neighbors. Zoya was very beautiful. She was beautiful in the sense that she had a very good sense of humor. Whenever she used to smile, she used to have a very good dimple on her cheek. One unique thing about Zoya was that she never missed the Raksha Bandhan festival. In spite of being a Muslim, she used to come to my place, tie me a Rakhi. And once when she had a Rakhi tied on my hand, she used to demand for chocolates. She had tremendous inclination for chocolates. And I tell you, friends, I used to have fights with her as far as these chocolates are concerned. Then things went on. Both of us got big enough. I had to carry on for further education of engineering. I had to move away from Bombay. But the thread of love and affection that had developed between me and Zoya continued. I used to have correspondence with her. I used to get greeting cards, postcards, and Rakhis too. And one thing was very sure. I even sent her the chocolates that she was very fond of. I sent them by registered IDs. Then, when my fourth semester results were out, I found myself that I didn't receive a Rakhi from her. I thought that there was some problem. I thought it might have been that Zoya might have involved herself in some sort of job, and as a possibility that she might have forgotten it. But still, when I came back to Bombay, I thought of visiting Zoya's place. As I was being told by the neighbors that Zoya had shifted 2 months before to Hyderabad, but I could make out from the feelings on the faces of my neighbors and as well as my parents that they were hiding something from me. Coincidentally enough, I had the chance to go back to Hyderabad, and I thought this might be the chance so that I can visit Zoya's place. Once when I went to Zoya's place, whatever I found there was totally astonishing. It was totally beyond imagination. I never imagined such a kind of thing. I was being taken to the hospital to find that Zoya was lying on a bed. Her face was totally mutilated. Her body was totally burnt, covered with a bomb. I had no words, but I could see the smile on her face, as if Zoya wanted to say something to her dear brother. I could see the pain in her eyes that she had. I wanted to catch hold of her hand, but it was badly burnt. I knew Zoya was not in a position to tie me a Rakhi, nor she was in a position to enjoy the chocolates that I had taken with me for her. The simple reason was that her mouth was totally burnt. She was not in a position to open the mouth. And I came to know from the doctors that Zoya was a mehman of a few days. Present Zoya is no more with me. I miss her, I love her. I used to love her, I loved her, I love her forever. People who were responsible for such a sort of tragic end to Zoya were not human beings. So I'll say, friends, they were animals in human races. Thank you.